In Greek mythology, the Hydra stands for invincible life, growing back two heads for each one lost. This legendary beast story is not just a tale for heroism and monsters, it's also a metaphor for one of the greatest challenges in modern medicine, cancer. Cancer cells, in our case prostate cancer, have the ability to regenerate. However, just as Heracles found a way to stop the Hydra's regeneration by cauterizing its necks, today's medicine is on the hunt for specific tumor traits, which could allow us to stop the way cancer cells survive. In metastatic castration-resistant prostate cancer, homologous recombination deficiency might be the trait we're looking for. This deficiency describes when a cell loses its ability to repair double-strand breaks using a specific repair mechanism, the so-called homologous recombination repair. But cancer cells have a second repair group, so the cancer cells keep on growing. In a tumor where the HRR pathway is defective, a specific class of drugs, known as PARP inhibitors, can target and knock the second repair group out of commission. Eventually, the DNA becomes so damaged that the cancer cells die. So testing for HRD really offers a great benefit for the patients. However, there is a major challenges arising, especially in prostate cancer. Where bone predominantic metastatic tumors make especially traditional tissue biopsies impractical and challenging to perform. So no wonder that especially our liquid biopsies are emerging as a viable alternative. Given that 20 to 30% of metastatic castration-resistant prostate cancer exhibit HRD, there's a clear need to assess the HRD status at any given time point. To assess the HRD, we can do it through two angles, namely from the causes, including the inactivation of HRR relevant genes through mutations, or its effects. In our study, we first checked for the causes of the HRD phenotype. For that, we pre-selected prostate cancer with higher tumor fraction and performed mutational profiling on around 140 prostate cancer patients. To this end, we used a customized gene panel enriching for 15 HRR relevant genes and also including TP53, RB1, and PTEN. Our analysis showed pathogenic alteration in HRR-relevant genes in around 50% of patients. But focusing solely on gene mutations may lead us to miss a significant number of patients with HRD that arise from causes other than gene mutations. For example, promoter methylation can also lead to an inactivation of HRR-relevant genes. As a result, we are now shifting our focus not only looking at the causes, but also to investigate its effects, marked as genomic instability and mutational signatures. So following, we checked for the genomic instability and calculated the underlying HRD score using shallow whole genome sequencing data. What we observe is that HRR mutated tumors, here depicted with BRCA2 mutations, harbor a high genomic instability, in contrast to HRR proficient samples. However, we also have some cases which show high genomic instability despite lacking HRR mutation. So there is no wonder that especially additional strategies need to be here to investigate these samples further. Overall, we selected 20 samples with and without HRR mutations and having high and low HRD scores. And this is exactly where the Illumina whole exome sequencing approach comes into play, to extend our mutation analysis and to investigate the mutational signatures. Using the new UMI-based chemistry, we enriched for the whole exome. We constructed libraries using plasma DNA and sequenced 8 samples on a S4 flow cell on a NovaSeq. Additionally, we also performed PBMC analysis. Upon evaluating of the quality parameters, we had a great on-target rate, and also the read enrichment was over 80%. The sequencing depth hits 1,500x, and we were pretty satisfied with the uniformity of coverage. In contrast to existing whole exome sequencing approaches, the Illumina UMI-based approach enabled us to detect mutations with a variant allele frequency below 5%. By analyzing a reference material containing 132 variants, we successfully detected all of them at a variant allele frequency at 5%. And remarkably, even at 1% variant allele frequency, we could detect more than 93% of them. So comparing the Illumina whole exome sequencing approach here depicted in gray with the Amplicon gene panel here in blue, we saw a high concordance between both methods. In most cases, whole exome sequencing was able to detect all the variants which were previously identified with the Amplicon gene panel. The variant allele frequency of those variants showed a nearly perfect correlation. Only few variants which were not detected with the whole exome sequencing data had the variant allele frequency below 1% using the HRR panel. Additional to mutation, we also aim to see whether mutational signatures could be extracted using the Illumina approach. And indeed, in patients harboring BRCA2 mutations or a high genomic instability, we identified the HRD-associated mutational signature. In one patient harboring high genomic instability, despite lacking HRR, we also observed the HRD-associated mutational signature, again suggesting that HRD may not only be caused by gene mutations. One additional case showed high numbers of alterations, including one alteration in an HRR-relevant gene. The mutational signature we identified is associated with defective DNA mismatch repair and microsatellite instability, suggesting that MSR high might be the driver of the tumor and not HRD. So, just as Heracles found a way to defend the Hydra, whole exome sequencing could be a powerful tool to extract the HRD status at any given time point. This fast and straightforward approach with high sensitivity enables us to see the causes and the effect of the HRD phenotype. In summary, as already Alexander Wyatt's group has shown that a holistic approach might really offer the most comprehensive insight into this biomarker. Enjoy Synapse and have fun in Graz.